You know, after them making a part 4, I never expected to make another one of this. In fact, after part 4, I was planning on retiring. But I'm not planning that anytime soon, because recently I got information about another situation that Jiwon has done, but from a person I have never expected to be from, that being K-Woo. You may have seen her before on his channel or have seen her content before, and noticed she was a defender of Jiwon during 2021. But why her? Out of all the people, why is she coming out? Well, to learn about the story, we're gonna have to take a look at more than her. In fact, we have to take a look at the whole situation one by one. This is the story of K-Woo. Also, just a little note here, the following video I'm going to be referring to her as Rose, just to make it more easier, and the fact that's what she also goes by. Sometimes throughout the video I'm going to refer to her as K, but I'm just getting a little fact before I start the video. Anyway, let's get into it. I first encountered Rose in the middle of 2021. And if I'm gonna be honest, it was rocky. She started off defending Jiwon and made a rant video on part 1 and later a remake. And neither of them were good. If you want our reaction to those videos, I recommend you watch these two videos that are showing up right now. I'll leave them in the link description. Okay, to be fair, I didn't like my first video either, so that's why I remade it. Okay, to get back on topic, throughout last year, we encountered her once a month. And it kinda got fucked up in my opinion. Like, for example, like getting death art of my character and at one point getting my face leak as well. She did draw Yoshi as well, but I'm not really kind of the one because technically his is more tame compared to mine. We also did go on the VC with her with a friend, and to put in short, we explained about the drama and we just goofed off and everyone had a good time.
What's another question?
Alright, Kay, if it's comfortable with you, can you go in specifics on what you agree with Jiwon and what you don't?
We're not gonna bash you. We just
want to know.
Uh-huh. I mean, there's not much, and I honestly don't know, to be honest. My brain's not working at the moment.
I mean, you're talking to the guy who had the profile picture with a penis for a nose.
Oh my god.
Okay, that's actually pretty funny.
Penis nose.
For about a few hours. Later on, we got a message from one of her friends, who now hates Jiwon, by the way, saying how we should be more nicer to Rose during a call. Which confused me and a lot of my friends, because technically we did get along. One of my friends later went up to Rose asking what the hell is this, and her response was she was stressed, but what she might have said was a little bit out of context. Like I said before, we encountered her once a month throughout that year, until she started to stop in December, where she let us mind her own business, until we saw her later again this year. But around late February to March, it went a bit strange. When I was about to take a look at her rant video with Yoshi, she made some notable changes to her videos. In fact, one of her most notable changes is the thumbnail for her first video on us. And in the description, she made an apology. And I know it's gonna sound strange, but I forgave her. Because unlike Jiwon and a certain person we'll get later on into the video, Rose actually took responsibility for her actions and not once blamed her action on her autism or anything she has, and didn't even blame her actions on other people. And unlike Jiwon, Rose had been proven to be changed and to become a better person. Sure, yeah, the apology is short, but hey, it's something and I actually like it. But that's not the only reason why I forgave her. Not just because she apologized, also what she went through throughout that time when she was gone, and to show what happened to her when she was with Jiwon. But before we do, we need to talk about another person that's involved in the situation. I know this looks confusing because this video is mostly about Rose, but trust me when I say that, but this segment is actually important to the story as well. On January 17th this year, I got in contact by a Kano lover, otherwise, believe it or not, Julian's girlfriend. She'd been asking a question on what the hell has been going on and seeing if there's a way that me and Julian can talk this out. So it went pretty fine for the first month and a half. Until she started giving me strange vibes. Throughout the time I've been with her, she'd been trying to use Julian's autism as an excuse for his actions, and saying how I should do my research on autism. Even though I know that's not how autism works, because I actually do have friends who actually do have autism, and none of them act like Julian. She even got mad at me at one point because she told me to not upload anything on Julian's birthday and let him have a break, which I didn't really care because I wasn't even planning to make a video during that time. She later got mad at me for uploading a video on Julian's birthday, which I was confused during that time because the video that she was referring to was Julian Marrero Part 3, a video that I have no development of, and the video was uploaded on the 6th. Julian's birthday is on the 7th, so I got in trouble for doing something I didn't even make? That's just fucking stupid. She also got in the set at Yoshi because on one of our live streams, Yoshi called Julian a pussy when he left. The same live stream where Julian threatened to rape someone. When I brought up the part on what Julian said in that live stream, she immediately tried to defend it by saying how Julian knew it was a bad word, but he didn't know what it meant. Which I find that bullshit to begin with, because if Julian didn't know what the word meant, why the fuck would he use it as a threat? What makes this even more confusing is the fact that after she mentioned about the fucking rape comment, she went back to talking about autism. I also been talking about Rose to Kena. Keep in mind, the screenshots you're about to see, it was during a time I didn't trust Rose. I've been mostly thinking about how Rose was manipulated because she didn't lie before. But for some reason, during a time, Julian wanted Kena to apologize for warning her about Rose, which doesn't make any sense at all, and I even called that out. I also brought up the fact that she tried to follow me on Twitter before, which I'll bring up later on, because trust me, these are fucking important. Now, before you're saying, FM, what the fuck does Kena have to do with Rose? Well, the reason why she's brought up here is what happened behind the curtain, and I consider one of the most fucked up things that Kena and Julian did during that time with Rose. Whenever I'm relaxing or just working on some videos, I get followed by Rose a lot. She's been trying to follow me, but I mostly block her a lot. All the accounts are just normal and easy to tell that's her. Except for two, which very fucking concerned me. I'm not gonna show neither of these accounts because technically I feel like they should be private with me. But to sum up one of them, it was basically about Kay crying on the banner saying how she needed help and with an arm or leg being cut. I really hope that's not a real picture of her, otherwise I've been fucking scared of what's going on with her. The last time she followed me was very strange, actually. The account was under by the name of Help, the profile picture being Julian with his face blacking out and another cut part of their body. I really hope that's not a picture of her still. I'm not gonna show the cut parts, but I am gonna show the new one. Why the hell are these accounts important? That's because one of them contained a Google Drive link, actually. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get it during that time, so basically I asked Kena for help. And sure enough, she managed to give me the link, which is something that she now regrets. Why exactly? Well, when I managed to open up the drive, it contained a bunch of folders. Each controversy is labeled in each different folder. The one that caught my eye was the one labeled Kena or Olivia. I thought that was confusing because why was she on there? As soon as I opened up, I can understand why. Rose wasn't the bad guy. Kena was. What made me so pissed off at Kena was the fact she made these two images. I got fucking mad at her and I immediately cut ties with her. She's been trying to say some dumb shit like, I guess that you don't like me anymore or some dumb shit like that. What got even more stupid is the fact that when she tried pointing some excuses, the one that caught me off was the one she said it was just a joke art, but Rose sent them to you. No, just no. First off, Rose has nothing to do with the drawings. You are more responsible for making these two fucking images. So don't bring up other people who have nothing to do with your drama, bitch. You knew you would get in trouble if I saw those images. You're not sorry for what you did. You're sorry that you got caught. I would talk more about her, but I already got two people who already do want to do that.
Well, hello there. Looks like it's my turn. And all I have to say is that Julian, Kama Lover, and any motherfucker who support these morons are more fucking retarded than a Karen screaming about me eating forest berries. I wanna start off my rant on the bitch herself, aka Kama Lover 111. Now in the beginning, she seemed like a nice person and just wanted the drama to stop altogether, which everyone including me couldn't agree more. But someone in Julian's server showed her true intentions and decided to warn us. And holy fucking shit. I was not expecting her to be this much of a backstabbing cocksucker. Me and the others took a good look at her shitty ass TikTok account and when I saw this video. I almost fucking snitched the video and called her out on this shit. You don't just fucking make a video asking for help for something so fucked up as drawing Funtime Mario 4. First off, SM is a real person and you decided to make fetish art out of him. What the actual fuck is wrong with you? Second, the fact that you're saying that Julian has autism and using it as an excuse for everything shitty he has done is like saying, I didn't shoot the guy, the gun shoot him. Honestly, people like you who use autism as any excuse should be fucking slapped. And last but not least, when you were called out, all you did was be a fucking pussy and try to push it off as a quote-unquote joke. Honestly, we all fucking knew you were lying and also a waste of human sperm alongside your dimwit of a boyfriend. Fuck you, nasty high school bitch! If you decide to make a video about this, expect me and everyone else to slap your bitch ass back into reality. Now that I'm done calling out Julian's human cum rag, it's time I actually talk about Chris Chan to himself. And if you thought I was done with him in my last video, well, it's time I make him perish again. Now Funtime Mario already explained what happened to Kay and what she went through, and honestly it's disturbing to see all the shit that Julian did to her, Blue, Mushroomy, and even his own mother. Now you see why I called him Chris Chan too. I hope he knows that everyone now knows what he has done, and the fact that you'll never change as a human being shows how disgusting you are. Hopefully there's a special place in hell for you, Julian. Oh, and if you're watching this, Julian, just to let you know that if you make a response on this video, I will make sure you suffer. You drew porn of your friends and family and expect to use your autism as a scapegoat. I hope to see you in hell, motherfucker, and the fact that you drew underage characters sexualized such as Victoria, who you admit yourself is 4 years old, makes me sick to my stomach knowing people like you exist. I hope you realize what you've done and hope that people such as Spyro the Moron and other dumbasses perish alongside you. Especially Spyro. Fuck you, you stupid fucking bitch. As I'm finally ending this part, I will be going back to my banana lunch, finally done dealing with these retards. Funtime Mario, you can now finish the job here. Have a good night, everyone, and hope to see you guys next time. I'll be watching over you, my little chimps.
Hello everyone, I'm Mushroomy, and I'm new to this channel. Now the reason why I'm here is to talk about someone, and by the looks of the channel you might know who they are from. Just to say, I'm actually the girlfriend of the person named Funtime Mario, and this actually makes me sick. So I'm actually new to this kind of stuff, so it might look bad, but there is the evidence to show and read. If you're done with the drama we did, you do this shit. You legit backstabbed us. You are sick. Oh, but just wait. There is something coming you, and you will see what we have found thanks to Anonymous. But I'm still disgusted. That's all I had to say right now. So Julian, and I forgot your name. Don't make a crying video about this, cause we all know those are crocodile tears. Anyways, goodbye. By the way, I'm trying my best not to make this rushed, but I'm just nervous.
Well, that was nice. Anyways, let's get on to the main point y'all been waiting for. And I can guarantee some of you been waiting for this one. Well, it was pretty obvious that Julian is going to be mentioned in this video. He's not like he's going to get a fucking pass for this one. But I say this for a very good reason, to show how Julian treated Rose. And I can guarantee you, it's fucking bad. To start off, let's talk about how Julian traces. Cause you know, Julian's art is incredibly original. But these ones are more concerning. Julian requests Rose a lot to trace herself, which I'll be showing right now. One of the most common themes for Julian to draw is basically him or any other character crying. And sure enough, he wanted to do that on Rose. The following audio you're about to listen to is Julian requesting Rose to cry because, in his own words, it's cute.
Your crying voice.
Oh, why?
Because you're crying voice.
Oh, why?
Because it's cute.
Excuse me, what?
It's cute.
You have a girlfriend, right?
Yes.
Then why are you doing this?
Because.
Simp.
It's cute.
The part that got very fucking disgusting is these roleplays that Julian tried to start, where he either has sex with Rose and doing very utter disgusting shit that I'm not even gonna mention. What gets fucking more disgusting is the fact that he requests and sometimes forces Rose to moan for him so he can masturbate to them. You wanna know how old Rose was when he started doing that shit? You know what? No, I'll let this video explain for you.
Dude, what the fuck are you doing?
Masturbating.
That's right. She was fucking 11. I genuinely wanna know how the fuck did no one think this was fucked up during that time. He even sometimes draw her naked or asked her to draw herself with big boobs and shit like that, which actually affected her a lot, which caused her to starve herself, actually. Holy shit. It's already pretty obvious to the point that Julian is fucking horny for Rose, even though that's disgusting. The fucker even drew her naked, said how he was thirsty for her, even told Kay to edit a drawing where she's blushing to say his name, which she didn't do, so Julian decided to draw instead. Oh wait, did I say draw? I meant fucking traced. She even made a comparison how Julian stole her character designs and ideas. Some of them are very obvious, like these ones here. This one, however, I don't see. But the last two are very fucking obvious. Julian even drew himself having sex with Kana and Rose. And if you think I'm gonna show you the uncensored version, well, no. And making EXE version of himself with the Sonic.exe crap. Even guilt tripping by saying how he was going to kill himself, like a lot, because of the controversy he was going under. And even showing off how he fucking obsessed over Rainbow Kitty, like a lot. Hell, the fucker even traced over one of my friend's drawings. And not even done with halfway through the list actually. Julian threatened to rape Rose 2 or 3 times, which proved my point that Kana's a fucking liar. And for some reason told Kana and Rose to have a moaning contest. He also forces Rose to draw porn of Victoria 10 or 19 times, even though he's aware that Victoria is a minor. Also to mention on what happened on Rose's birthday, you wanna know what Julian did? He wanted Rose to trace herself in a sexual situation and also add him in there. What the fuck is wrong with this guy? And to top all this shit off, Rose was on the urge to kill herself because of what Julian has done to her. And also, Kana did nothing to stop him. The fact that all of this shit happened and no one realized this was fucked up is fucking idiotic and disgusting. I'm questioning what the fuck is wrong with these two retards. Oh, and speaking about them, let's talk about how they respond to their allegations. When Kana and Julian got their hands on the Google Drive, both responded to the allegations behind it, and all of them were fucking awful. I'm gonna be mainly talking about Julian's apologies because I already have someone about to do Kana's apology in this video. So, how did Julian first respond to the drive? Was a fucking crying video. Friendly reminder, he made this after he saw the drive. Later on, he will make another apology. And this one made me wanted to beat him with a fucking hammer. I'm gonna be using an AI voice to read this because honestly, I am gonna be very fucking pissed off if I do.
I deserve no purpose in life.
Julian, that's the wrong purpose.
I just can't take my life anymore. Everything is just too hard for me. They think I'm the villain.
No shit, look what you did, asshole.
I don't deserve anything. I don't deserve any friends. All I deserve is nothing. I've been nothing but a piece of shit. I wish that Funtime Mario and his friends can live without me. Because they don't even care about me anyway.
Yeah, and neither do you because you practically ignore the drama or fucking blame on other people.
I always get yelled at. I got bullied too many times. I got bullied in school.
You know, I would feel bad for you, but after learning about the shit you had done, I don't even fucking care.
I thought that becoming a pedophile was the right choice.
How the fuck did you think that becoming a pedophile was the right choice? That is nothing that you should be proud of, Julian. Seriously, how the fuck can you be this fucking retarded?
But no, it's not. Being a pedo is not right. I have been a complete dumbass ever since I heard it high five cause this was all my fault. I deserve to be accused. I deserve to be attacked. Exposed, being made fun of. The Julian allegations was right about me. I'm done with my life right now. I have told the truth until Maxim and G appointed the truth.
No you fucking didn't, you blamed it on him. And you said jack shit to Gio, all you did was say was fucking sorry and he wanted an answer. And you never gave it to him.
This is why I have no purpose in living anymore.
Also again, wrong purpose, Julian.
They always make my life worse. Funtime Mario thinks that I'm a bad guy.
You blame your actions on me, you fucking asshole.
Back in 2020, I used to sexualize minors. And I don't do that anymore.
Even if the shit you did was in 2020, you still continue it in 2021 and this year. You still do that, Julian.
I used to support Animator 320 and I used to act like him back then. And I stopped supporting him on this year. I wish I can just be happy again.
So did the people that you used for your events, Julian. And that's gonna be very nearly impossible because of the shit you've done, asshole.
I want my life to be better, instead of depressing, sad, misery, pain, or agony.
Are you seriously acting like the fucking victim?
When I grow up, I just wanna start a new life, and have a family, my own family. I would have a beautiful wife, beautiful kids. I would have started a new life. I want my life to be better.
Too bad, fucker. That ain't gonna happen anytime soon.
I don't want my life to be in a depressing place anymore. I need some mental health to help me. I don't wanna be-
Just stop! The fact you wrote this like you're the fucking victim in the situation, even though you clearly wrote that you thought that being a pedophile was the right choice, is fucking stupid. Dear God. Look, I know I should have expected this to be bad. It's an apology from Julian after all. But this shit feels soulless. The fact you wrote the apology like you're the fucking victim, lying about stop sexualizing minors and any other stuff. The fact you thought that becoming a pedophile was a good choice and ignoring the situation you did with Blooming Dog and Rose. Now I think about it, You didn't even mention Rose once in his dog shit apology. I already mentioned the fact that he wrote it like he's the fucking victim, but you have fucking hurt of Blue and Rose so badly. One of them even had the fucking urge to commit suicide because of you, fucking asshole. Manipulating them with their fucking fake cries or threatening to kill yourself multiple times and blaming your action on your quote-unquote past when the shit you done was so bad that the fact you can't even use that fucking excuse. Plus, the shit you done wasn't even that fucking old. So do me a favor, shut the fuck up and go fuck yourself. Because this is just fucking insulting in so many ways. By the way, let's get on with Kena's apology. And trust me, I already have a friend who wants to talk about her.
I might as well get this fucking part for you done. Because I really fucking hate this bitch. If you guys don't know who I am, I'm Yoshi Kingmaster. I run the live streams most of the time when it comes to the Julian Allegation channel. But this time, I want to respond to this apology video that Kena made for Funtime Mario. I want to call out all the bullshit she has said. Without further ado, I will be playing the video for you guys with a little bit of commentary. Hope you guys enjoy this part.
Hi. I don't really know who I'm gonna be sending this to, but I just wanted to say that I'm sorry. Funtime Mario has been spreading some false information about my friend.
We actually gather evidence of Julian doing this fucked up shit. And the fact that you're saying that we're quote unquote spreading rumors or lies about him, it just shows that you were one-sided the whole fucking drama. You didn't want the drama to end, you just wanted us to shut the fuck up. Honestly, you're a piece of shit human being for defending this. Saying that we fucking lie. What the fuck is wrong with you?
But that doesn't mean that I'm completely innocent, though. I have done some bad stuff. I can agree, like that art that I did.
It's not just the artwork that you did. You basically backstabbed us and literally treat us like we're pieces of shit. And Julian is in the right. Spoiler alert, he's not. Look at all the shit that you and Julian have done. You've done nothing to help except lie behind our backs like a fucking cunt that you are.
I understand now that that was the wrong thing to do, and I've faced the consequences, and now Funtime Mario and Yoshi hate me.
Gee, Einstein, I fucking wonder why we fucking hate you, you fucking donut.
And I understand that what I did was wrong, and it's just, I don't really know what to say. I'm disappointed at myself.
No, you're not. You literally went on TikTok after we found those images, and you started crying to your TikTok followers saying,
"Oh, I drew porn of this person. Please help me, please."
Honestly, if a regular person actually saw your TikTok, they would fucking make sure that your life is a living hell.
I should have never done that. I'm sorry, okay? I just want this drama to stop. That's all I want.
The fact that you literally say, "I want the drama to end," and then, "Oh, they're spreading rumors about Julian." It's just pick a side. But, oh wait, you can't because you hate us with a fucking burning passion. And I called it out. Look at these fucking drawings. Look at the drawings that you fucking made. You lying piece of shit. You don't want the drama to end. You want to continue it and make us look like the fucking assholes. You're a fucking asshole, dude.
I don't like to see my friends upset. I don't like to see my friends crying and angry and mad. I just I just want everybody to live in peace. I don't want all this drama to continue.
Then you shouldn't have fucking backstab us, dumbass.
Julian's only 14.
Hey, buddy, there's a little thing that everybody's been talking about. It's called Nobody Gives a Fucking Shit.
He didn't know that he did anything wrong. But again, that doesn't mean that I'm completely innocent. And that doesn't mean he's completely innocent either. The things that Julian did were wrong. Some of the things that Julian did were very bad. But I can assure you, he didn't mean any of it to harm anyone.
I call bullshit on that. Remember the time when Julian literally mentioned that he was gonna rape someone in the comment section in one of his videos? Remember the fucking time when he literally threatened to rape KOO multiple fucking times? And remember that he fucking masturbated to a lot of people in call multiple fucking times? Dude, shut the fuck up. Seriously, no, shut the fuck up. You're terribly defending this motherfucker for all the fucking wrong reasons. Honestly, I honestly hate this bitch with a burning passion. What the actual fuck is wrong with you? How the fuck do you defend someone who literally thought that being a pedophile is a good thing? You fucking retarded piece of shit. Honestly, fuck you, and whoever fucking defends these two motherfuckers, go to hell.
He just didn't understand. He didn't understand. He doesn't understand cause and effect, and he didn't know that what he did was wrong and that it would have consequences. So again, I'm really sorry about all of this drama that has happened for the past year or so, and I really hope that we can find peace.
No, fuck your peace. Take your fucking peace and shove it up your ass, you Sheen SFS looking motherfucker.
Without having to just harass one another.
And that's the end of her apology. Honestly, the only thing I gotta say is fuck you, fuck Julian, and fuck your shitty little apology. FM, you can take over. I am done responding to this bitch. Goodbye, everybody. I'll remember you all in therapy.
So recently I have more information about Kena. At the time I'm writing this down, she made another apology video, this time being unscripted. And no, it's not good either. But what caught me in Yoshi's eyes is the fact she wanted to settle this on DMs rather than a video coming out. Yoshi was technically pissed off because he actually did offer to talk to her before she released that video, but she took the whole day for a response. So rather than a DM talk, he rather decided to do a VC, and he brought me along as well. And if I'm gonna be honest with you, it did not went well. Unlike Rose when it had a good start and actually had a kind of terrible ending, Kena's was worse from the beginning and in the end. She didn't want him to speak, so rather that she decided to play a sticky note and saying how we just stopped talking about Julian, which is a very fucking stupid thing to say. And to make her situation worse, she decided to play sad music in the background, like Just a Burning Memory, to give you one example.
Not only that, but she's playing fucking sad music while writing shit.
Okay. So
no, she's actually no, she's texting me.
Yoshi and I wanted her to fucking speak up about the situation, until she finally decided to speak up. The first thing we asked her about is this thing called a Funtime Mario bot. If you don't know what the hell that is, basically in her server, she made a bot for Julian so he can interact with it, and she admitted that she was the one who made it.
Oh yeah, by the way, didn't Julian try to throw you under the bus at one point by saying, that you made the bot?
Yes, he actually did that.
Yeah.
I did.
I did make the bot.
We also asked Julian about the situation, and he said that he didn't interact with it. And we all know, Julian's a very honest he fucking interacted with a bot. So basically, to sum this part in short, she meant that she made a bot, but Julian denied interacting with it even though there's evidence that he did. So in other words, he threw Kena under the bus, because he actually meant that she made a bot as well, which, sure, yeah, she was honest, but he tried to make him more innocent saying how he didn't, even though it's clear that he fucking did.
But I will say this, but I think it's both of y'all's fault, because y'all were both participating in, like, making fun of the bot and whatnot.
But he was trying to throw you under the bus and make him seem innocent, and you, like, the bad guy. Basically, he was trying to be the victim, and you, the bad guy.
We also asked her about the sex drawing, and honestly, I wanted to fucking yell at her. You know what, I'm not gonna say what's the problem, I'm gonna let this clip speak here.
Good to you? Like, yes, he supports you, but, like, is he, like, really good to you? Like, is he treating you like a queen? Like, that's what...
Yeah. He is. He's so nice to me.
But then, why is he doing like how come he didn't break up with him, like, when you noticed that he did that?
Not to mention, like, to Rose. Like, did you feel, like, okay, so take your time on this question, but did you feel uncomfortable when he drew you having sex with him?
Yes, but I was, don't get upset with me. Like I said, like, it did make me feel uncomfortable, but I did say, like, if you wanted to draw that, then it was okay. But
okay, I'm gonna stop right here, because basically, if it was just you hugging and kissing, I'm fine with that, but the fact when he did sex, that's actually child pornography.
Okay, mm-hmm. I know, I knew you were gonna say that, and yes, I agree, so.
So, let me get this straight. You got mad over a video that I didn't even make and wasn't uploaded on Julian's birthday, but yet your stupid ass let Julian draw porn of you even though you were aware that you were uncomfortable, but you were fine with it as long as he was fine with it? Do you not hear how fucking stupid you sound? And the only reason why she stayed with him because he treated her nice. Yeah, and he also did it to Blue and Rose, and look how that happened. After the call, she let her block us a few days later because we were being mean to her. Well, she's gonna learn the hard way. Also, a friend of mine who actually experienced this type of situation before will actually like to talk about it, so here he is. Sorry if it seems there's like a lot of people in this video, but they actually know about this Julian situation and they want to speak out about their part.
So, Julian Marrero, as you may all know or may be familiar with, is indeed a sick person. For those not aware, he has been drawing child porn, he has been grooming, and he has sexualized his very own mother, and even traumatized a certain someone named Blue Mean Dog, which I'll get into later. Now, this is where things get very disgusting, is how I'll put it, at least. His actions, this is just a few examples, because the thing is, he has done so much more to the point where I actually feel sick to my stomach. But luckily, from all the evidence we've gathered, it's easy to say that Julian Marrero is guilty. And not to mention, we did get a lot of help through it. But one thing that has angered me, if not by one of the most, is the fact that autism has been used as an excuse for his actions. I mean, at some pissed, but believe me, my blood is actually boiling like crazy. So excuse my language, but how the fuck does that make it okay? Short answer is that it doesn't in the slightest. I know his kind. I've dealt with a person like him before. I'm not new to this, and Julian cannot fool me. He can't fool anybody. We can tell you're acting. We can tell that you're fully aware of what you've been causing. You understand, and you're not confused, as some people may say. Anyways, moving on from that, my experience with this so far, and my opinion to share, is that I've only seen and heard the evidence, but I've never actually got to meet Julian himself. But what him and his fan base doesn't understand is that how disgusting of scum he really is. Now you see, the man literally drew child porn. Not to mention what we're trying to make him stop is what we're trying to do. It's what I want him to do, and it's to quit his antics. I don't want to hear more excuses and that you're so-called a victim. And especially by going back to the child porn part, you have drawn real minors as not safe for work. You've violated the rights of human beings. And you've even caused trauma of Blue Meme Dog. But it's not just Blue Meme Dog now, is it? It's more than her. And just hearing his name, they get panic attacks, and I can understand that. But of course you wouldn't get it. You don't understand the pain you caused others, and you have no empathy at all for them. Not to mention repeatedly you keep saying, oh, I'm gonna kill myself. Well, you won't ever do it. You just want your sympathy points. That's how we see it. That's how I see it. And I'm not done with that. I know you're acting. I've dealt with a person like you before with their guilt tripping that, oh, I'm going to kill myself for this and this. Well, look, you caused this. This is your fault. You led everything to this point where we are now, where we stand to this day. It's been a year. And what you can't seem to get for your fixed skull is your actions have consequences. You guilt trip, you manipulate, you play dumb like you don't know what you're doing, but the fact is you really do. Sorry if I may be getting heated, but I hate seeing repeated things like this. It generally makes me quite agitated. You really treat these people like toys, like they don't even matter, and then you replace them with new ones. And they're the so-called victims. That's not, we're not even halfway through what I have to discuss, actually. But I can't say more than this because I'm not joking when I say that it actually makes me sick that I feel I'm going to throw up. And I just hope that these victims get to heal quicker than it should, because this is not what should be done. Like, this has to be handled. And that's what we're doing. We've made all these parts. And therefore, I will have to say that I'm done. I'm simply done. And this isn't the first time I've dealt with this. I'm not new to this entire situation. And you're beyond sick, Julian. I hope you get that through your head. And that's where I leave this recording for now. Goodbye, folks.
So far, we learned that Julian is incredibly fucked up and has proven that he hasn't changed. Can't believe that there's still good in Julian, even though it's clear that there isn't any at all. And Rose. Despite doing all the shit she did to us, she didn't deserve to be treated like this by Julian. As I said before, she's been getting help and she's been hanging out with us. Though that doesn't mean these two get away with it. Don't be surprised when one of them mocks the situation or been trying to hide their action or blame it on their past, even though it's clear that this is recent as hell. Because the more evidence that pops up, the more they try to play the victim card. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope I get to see you next time.